about 4 years now, I can see that this is about the most contested elections, because quantitatively in terms of number of candidates, there are 33 who are in the contest. And also when you look at the deployment of the politicians' resources, we have records being broken. Especially those of us who've been to the hinterland, and we get reports from people. Of course, Nigeria has the highest number of aliens here. But we're not alien, because Nigeria was an emperor here. This was Oyo Empire. And the northern part of Nigeria was also the Bogu Empire. We have 7 ethnic groups we share together, and we have 778 kilometers of borders. So we are the same people, and I'm happy for them. That, you know, Benin is a champion of democracy in West Africa, having been in participative democracy for 25 years, and Nigeria less 9 years less. We can see that in spite of the resources that are limited in Benin, don't forget Benin is part of the SDC, least developed country, in terms of GDP. But then you can see the efforts of both the government and the people of Benin. And we are very envious of them, because they are very peaceful people and they are not easily provoked. We just pray and want to believe that it will end peacefully as it has started. And we are happy for Benin. There could be some hiccups there and there about distribution of cards. There's no doubt about that. But you know, whenever you have human organizations, there's bound to be some glitch. And I believe they will be able to, you know, overcome this. Let's hope for the best, that the best candidate will win, and that our wonderful relationship bilateral with Nigeria will continue, in fact, with much, much impetus.
And I learned that.